Mr. TV Sandeep Reddy, the Managing Director. Sandeep, thank you very much for joining us. Well, have you started production, and do you already have PPAs in place?
Yeah. Out of the 2,650, as you know, the first project was commissioned nearly a year and a half ago, and this year will be the first full year of operations, and that has the PPA for 85% of the total production, which is approximately 1,000 megawatts.
No, I meant for the second one, which
for the new project. For the new project, we are actually the L1 bidder in for a 500 megawatt PPA, and which is yet to start. I think we are yet to get. It's a work in progress because it's a regulator for approval, and also the PPA would, as per plan, would start only from January 2018. So that's why I think the regulator is taking some more time to clear it. And in the meantime, we are fully sold out with the short-term power for the entire 1320 megawatts. For this whole year, we have short-term contracts from Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Telangana, and also some alternative supplies to other companies like Adani and KSK Power to supply the power to Tamil Nadu.
Sandeep, just want to understand, what is the cost per unit currently? I mean, what is the current tariff rate to get a sense of the short-term PPAs that you have signed?
The short-term PPA average price will be around 375.
And is that that is your cost of production, 375?
No. That not 375 is our revenue. Cost of production could be, about 2 rupees 10 paisa is the variable cost, is what our cost is.
Okay. What do you expect you will be able to manage in terms of capacity? Because you're speaking about January when that PPA will,
we have PPAs for the short term, as I told you.
That's what I'm asking you. What is the approximate capacity utilization you expect?
No, we have short term. We have all PPAs for 100% of the capacity, but it's only and it's now subject. Now this year's capacity utilization will be one subject to the availability of the plant in the new plant. Oh. Normally, in the first year, there will be some breakdowns due to availability issues, and also offtake issues. Put together, we expect to do around nearly 70% PLF.
Like,
for example, our other plant, just to give a perspective. This March, we would be more or less concluding with a PLF around 80%.
All right. Sandeep, also I wanted to ask you about, you all had undertaken some restructuring as well as listing of BOT assets. What's the update over there? When can we see that listing?
We are hoping to close by in the next couple of months. We have applied to NCLT. For the demerger proposal.
Okay.
We got all the approvals from the secured and unsecured creditors of both the company.
Okay.
So it's under process now. I think once NCLT, we may take a couple of months. Probably the latest we will probably complete this whole thing by end of April or May, with them from 1st April 2017.
Okay. We were only wondering, the Navi Mumbai airport orders have now started trickling in. Is there anything in and around that that is in your kitty or likely to fall into your bag?
No, nothing else. This is the first site leveling project which we got. But part of the airport, I think the expectation is that CIDCO would come out with at least some more infrastructure works like approach roads and flyovers and all that, which I think are yet to be tendered in the next 1 year.
Okay.
And also the other big project we are qualified in is the Mumbai Trans Harbour Link. We are one of the qualified bidders.
Okay. And what is the timetable for its construction?
That is a 4-year construction, and the tenders are supposed to be concluded in the next quarter.
Okay. So we will
be bidding for those. Yeah.
Oh, really? Okay. Sorry. Yeah. You spoke about this year, about 80% of your capacity backed by short-term PPAs. What is the average revenue?
Long-term. Long-term PPAs, as I told you, for the first project, the thermal power tech, 80%, 85% long-term PPA, the average revenue is around 4 rupees.
Yes. I meant for the new project, the new project,
we have only the PPA, as I told you, only for one unit, which comes to around 50%. Mm-hmm. Long-term PPA, what I mean.
Okay.
The average tariff of that would be 4+. But the short-term tariffs, what we are having today, average comes to around 360.
360.
Mm. All right.
Sandeep, it's online with the market now.
You've given us a fair bit of details. Then for the next few years, what kind of a growth are you penciling in? Can you do a CAGR of around what, 30% approximately for the next 3-4 years, if you could tell us that, and your margins?
No. The growth for which one you're saying? The standalone?
Your growth, revenue, sir, going ahead.
Revenue for the power business or the construction?
Your consolidated revenues. I think in the past you had told us that you're looking at a growth rate of around 30%. So if you could break it up for us as well, we'll be fine.
Yeah, that's mostly the construction revenue. As you know, we have an order book today of about nearly 12,000 crores plus.
12,000,
and it has to be completed next year. So we are hoping to do average 20-25% revenue growth from this year onwards, from FY18 onwards.
What's your debt?
The debt is around 1,900 crores, standalone debt.
Okay, and consolidated debt would be?
Consolidated now would be, because we own less than 50% in the power plant, so we don't consolidate the debts of the power plant. And as you know, it's JV with Sembcorp. And also on the roads, once we demerge, we will not be consolidating the debt. The road debt is around 3,000 crores, for which it will, that's mostly project debt.
Okay. All right. We'll leave it at that. Thank you very much, Sandeep Reddy, for joining us with those details.